So let's go ahead and in this part find out what value of y sub 1 is, because we have I equal to 0. Your initial value of x is 0. Your initial value of y is 7. And your initial value of z, which is the same as the derivative of y, is 13. So armed with these values of x, y, and z, we can now calculate our value of y1, which we need to calculate first. So we need to calculate y1, z1 first to calculate y sub 2 next time, so in the next step. So what is y sub 1? Y sub 1 is nothing but y sub naught plus 1 half case of 1 y plus 1 half k2 y of h. Let me not do that. Let me just first, rather than writing that, let me just calculate my case of 1 values. So I need case of 1 y. This is what I was talking to you about just a few minutes ago, is that we need to calculate case of 1 y first, then case of 1 z, then case of 2 y, and case of 2 z to be able to calculate the corresponding slopes. So case of 1 y is nothing but the value of the function f1 calculated x naught, y naught, and z naught, because I is equal to 0. And f sub 1 is nothing but what? The f sub 1 is nothing but z. But let's just populate this. x0 is 0, y0 is 7, z0 is 13. And f sub 1 is nothing but z. Since f sub 1 is nothing but z, that is just the value of this. This is 13. So that's what we get for case of 1 y. Now I want to calculate case of 1 z, which is nothing but the second function f sub 2, at the same arguments which we had for case of 1 y. So what that means, x0 is 0, y0 is 7, z0 is 13. What is f sub 2? F sub 2 is nothing but 11 e to the power minus x, which is 0 in this case, minus 3 times z, which is 13, minus 5 times y, which is 7, divided by 2. And this value here turns out to be minus 31.5. So we have calculated case of 1 y and case of 1 z for corresponding to I equal to 0. Let's now calculate the case of 2 values and see what we get from there. So we get, case of 2 y will be now the function f1, but now calculated x0 plus h, y0 plus 1 half, y0 plus case of 1 y h, case of 1 y h, and z0 plus k1 z of h. So what is x0? x0 is 0, h is 0.25, because that's the step size. y0, we just calculated to be 7. Case of 1y, we just calculated to be 13. And h is 0.25. So that's the argument of y, which you want to have. Now let's see what the argument of z is. The argument of z is what? Is 13. Plus k1 of z, which is minus 31.5, which we just calculated, times 0.25. And let's go and see what the arguments are at which we have to calculate the function f1. So it turns out to be x1 is 0.25. This argument here turns out to be 10.25. And this argument here turns out to be 5.125. So you got to understand what these arguments are. This is the corresponding value of x which you have at the point ahead. This is the approximate value of y at the point ahead at 0.25. And it's the corresponding value of z, the first derivative of y respect to x, at 0.25. Because you need all these three arguments, although these are approximate values, to be able to calculate, get some feel of what f sub 1 is. So f sub 1 is nothing but z, so that turns out to be just 5.125, because it's just the value of z. Now let's calculate case of 2z. Case of 2z is nothing but f sub 1 at the same f sub 2, which is the second function f. And it's at the same arguments as this one, so we don't need to recalculate this. So we have 0.25, 10.25, 5.125. That's what we need to calculate f sub 2. Now f sub 2 is nothing but 11 e to the power minus the value of x, minus 3 times the value of z, which is 5.125, minus 5 times the value of y, which is 10.25, and divided by 2. And that gives me this value here. Turns out to be equal to case of 2z, turns out to be minus 29.029. So we have all the values which we need now. We have case of 1y, case of 1z, case of 2y, and case of 2z to calculate our value of y at y sub 1. So let's go ahead and do that. What we're going to get is we have y sub 1. By putting x equal to I equal to 0, I get y sub 1 is equal to y sub 0 plus 1 half case of 1y. Plus 1/2 case of 2y times h. So y naught we know is the initial value of y, which is 7. Case of 1y we calculated just now to be 13, and case of 2y we just calculated to be 5.125, and h is 0.25, and this value here turns out to be 9.2656. So this is the approximate value of y1 at 0.25. So let's calculate z1 now, because we do need the value of z1 to be able to calculate the corresponding value of y at x2. So we cannot just skip and go to y2, because we need the value of z1 there. So z1 is z0 plus 1/2 the slope case of 1z, 1/2 the slope called case of 2z times h. So let's go and substitute the values which we just found out. So we get z0, which is the initial value of z, which is 13, plus 1/2 case of 1z, we just calculated to be minus 31.5, plus 1/2 case of 2z is minus 29.029 times h, which is 0.25. So that gives me the value of z1 to be 5.4339. So that's what gives me the value of y1 and z1. And the immediate next segment, I'm going to show you the next step. And that's the end of this segment.